Maltese Falcon was my father's first big movie. And his first collaboration of many with John Huston.
Hey, what's this bird, this falcon that everybody's all steamed up about?
Supposing I wouldn't tell you anything about it at all, what would you do? Something wild and unpredictable.
They just had such a mutual respect for each other that I think my father loved it not only because of the movie and not only because of Hammett, but because it was his first collaboration with the person who would become his best friend and would give the eulogy at his funeral, as a matter of fact.
You aren't exactly the sort of a person you pretend to be, are you?
Well, I'm not sure I know exactly what you mean.
Lock that door.
You know, George Raft was the first choice to play my father's part, Sam Spade, and he turned it down, among other things. You know, I mean, we love George Raft because he turned down all these good parts.
Miles hadn't many brains, but he'd had too many years' experience as a detective to be caught like that by a man he was shadowing up a blind alley with his gun in his hip and his overcoat button.
My father was a very exacting guy. And he liked the way Huston had everything planned out. And, you know, he shot it in sequence, which was very important to my father as an actor. And it showed the innovation that Huston brought to the screen. One of our greatest directors, if not our greatest director ever.
In short, sir, I must ask you for my 10,000.
It is the quintessential detective film.
This will take care of my time and expenses.
Oh, after 17 years.
You know, the Ruby Slippers and the Maltese Falcon are possibly the two greatest pieces of film memorabilia that you can own. It's a prime example of the fabled MacGuffin, which is the part of the movie, which is a prop in the movie that is central to the movie, but really doesn't have anything to do with it.
What is it?
The stuff that dreams are made of.
Huh?
Bonhams has the actual Maltese Falcon with a dent in it. You can see the dent in the Maltese Falcon on the screen in the same place that you have the one that's for sale at Bonhams. And that's better than any signature. It's right there in front of your face. Now that's priceless. That is priceless. I love that. Huston was a very literary guy. He really looked for the writing. I mean, the shooting and all that other stuff was one thing, but it's the writing that he looked for. This one, Huston stuck really, really close to the script, and that's why it was so successful. The Treasure of the Sierra Madre is one of the true classic films, and I think to have a script that was marked by Huston is a phenomenal gift, you know, to see how the man thought. This is going to be just so much fun as an auction. I'm so glad that Bonhams is doing it.